Pfizer, $19 billion.
Was that a quarter or a year?
In Q2.
What?
Quarter. In the second quarter. Oh, that's over $200 million a day. But you know what else? Their blood thinning medication that may be used also for clots, the sales went up double digits. Guess what? Their drug available for people who have heart complications, for example, maybe something like myocarditis, we don't know, went up over 70% as far as sales. We do know it's proven to help with liver damage. We do know it's proven to help with your lungs. We do know that it has a very high safety threshold and therapeutic window. We know all these things, and we know that the FDA started saying, you better stop selling this now, right? They were all scared into silence. Now, give me a minute to explain this, because this is a big big situation. So you may not have seen this. We weren't on YouTube. We weren't on YouTube while we talked about this.
Yeah.
There is a supplement out there called NAC, N-acetylcysteine. It's an amino acid. And while we were live on air, you've used it for a long time. We found out that it was banned, or I guess to speak very clearly, the FDA had reached out and threatened manufacturers who had been carrying this distributors for many, many years, saying you can't carry it because now it's a drug, which is unprecedented, by the way.
It was some kind of like head fake that they were doing that really kind of scared some people, right?
Yes.
But at the time of this article coming out, the article was reading like, this is now banned, Amazon has pulled it, and you can't get it from there.
So just for people who missed it, because we weren't on YouTube for these 2 weeks, this is available on Rumble. This happened live on air, and that forced us to do some digging. And again, you're not supposed to be able to talk about these things, but we will.
Do you remember the NAC stuff that I was telling you about that you take before drinking?
Yeah, it's what they give you if you overdose on Tylenol in the hospital.
Exactly, right. So they actually just pulled that from being over-the-counter. I just learned about this just the other day because we use those a lot. I'm in the wine business. And they've made it prescription only now. And the theory behind it is that it actually is somewhat helpful in treating some symptoms maybe that you can get from COVID-19.
Really?
So yeah,
you can't get NAC as a supplement?
Go look at it now. I went to Amazon yesterday when I read this article. Go on Amazon or anywhere else right now and Google NAC, and you'll see it come up, but you'll see products that are not NAC anymore. You can no longer get that over the counter, and it's just
it must be very recent because I have it.
It was yesterday.
So let me be really clear about this. This is something, and again, we're not promoting.
No, we're not
saying zinc stops COVID.
So it turns out you may have been wrong.
Yes.
That it may not be banned, but the FDA is heading towards banning it from being a supplement. Now, I'm not a doctor, and let me be really clear, this is not medical advice. At the advice of my doctor, I have consistently throughout COVID, and these are all things, by the way, that you can do in addition to mask, vaccines.
Yeah, yeah.
Not saying to do them as a substitution.
Mm-hmm. Right.
Zinc, quercetin, which just helps my whole goal has been to reduce viral replication.
Yeah.
In the body, because viral load affects your symptoms.
Yeah.
Zinc, quercetin. You can read the clinical data on that. NAC, and I'll explain to you why, and just a xylitol nasal rinse with saline solution. That's it. The whole point is to reduce the viral load. It either worked for me to the point that I was asymptomatic, or I never caught it because I was surrounded by people who had COVID, my family. By the way, they're all fine. I repeat myself.
And it's not just for potentially any
COVID not just
stuff.
For
it's
that.
Other stuff, right?
So absolutely.
Common cold and other things that you might kind of
and
run into.
And you took the NAC and the vitamin D?
I didn't take vitamin D. No, I took NAC, zinc, quercetin, and a saline nasal spray with xylitol.
Because I was watching a pretty convincing video last night. Again, not a doctor, YouTube. Just saw a video.
Putting it out there.
Where they're saying that it was really a vitamin D deficiency that's causing us to have the immune problems.
Yeah.
And that there's not really a flu season or cold season. There's just this
low vitamin D season.
Low vitamin D season.
Now, here's the problem with that.
See, and he's already seen the video.
No, but here's the problem with the problem with that is there. It's sort of looking at a population correlation, right?
Yeah.
Low vitamin D, and there is a strong correlation. For me, anytime I use a supplement or anytime I use, I've got to actually see the mechanism of action and why it works in that scenario. Not just going, hey, people with lower vitamin D tend to get sick more.
Yeah.
There's a mechanism of action with NAC specifically that relates to COVID. Now, you've been familiar with it. For people who don't know, I want to know people out there, if you've known about this, if you've not been able to purchase it, again, we didn't plan on doing a deep dive into this.
No, not at all.
But it's really concerning. So what is it? Okay, look, let me explain to you exactly what NAC is. So NAC is basically an amino acid. It's basically, you could call it like a derivative amino acid.
Yeah.
What it is your body uses it to create this thing called glutathione. That's your master antioxidant in your body. Okay,
yeah.
Your body creates this antioxidant. It's at its highest concentrations in the liver,
yeah.
And it's also at high concentrations in the lungs. Now, there are other arguments that it also has immune modulating effects. But the point is, NAC actually, and you can bring this up as an overlay, and then I'll show what people find on YouTube when they search for it. I drank a bottle of children's Tylenol as a kid.
Right.
With my mom. She was giving us medicine, and all done. Proud of me? No, you're going to die.
Downed it, man.
What do they do in hospitals? They give you intravenous NAC. It works. It is medically used.
Yeah.
right? Because it actually, you've heard the term detox? No, no. Your dandelion root isn't going to detox you if you drink a bottle of children's Tylenol. Right. Yeah. You go to a hospital, they IV NAC to you, and it's the same reason that people who drink, like you do a lot of wine tastings, NAC
yeah.
helps protectively against the liver. That's how you came
That's exactly, yeah, exactly. This is how I found out about it. And honestly, I was telling people, like, I drink wine for a living. And so
too much.
That could, no, Dave, I know, but still.
Too much.
But one glass a day or something like that. No, I still take it every single time, but there are other times where I drink more. I actually was pushing this to my clients. I was like, take this. This will help you out immensely. Even if you only have a glass, it's just good for liver health. And a nurse fact-checked me. She pulled up her phone and goes, oh, yeah, they do give it to you in the hospital if you go in with an overdose of
acetaminophen.
Right. Oh, weird.
Weird.
Yeah, yeah, you okay. bought a lot of NAC, though, and
I did.
Look, I but, just think yeah. it's time that we bring this
yeah, up. In other words, it's not the problem with NAC. It's that NAC is a symptom of something.
Much more right. severe, well, which yeah. is...
What's happening?
Gerald, we're not actually on a live show today.
Yeah. No.
What? This is an intervention, mm-hmm. and... Yeah.
Didn't you notice when the red blinking light wasn't on? You'd think we'd waste this much time on air with him spraying CFCs?
It makes no sense.
This is a lot of cover. Do I have a problem?
Well, see, we think you do. And yeah. I'm glad that you asked because the answer is yes.
I have a problem.
And yep. we think that, in fact, you sat here yesterday and the seat is quite uncomfortable. And it's, oh, see?
Yeah.
Oh, come wow. on.
Yeah. Old elk.
Yeah.
No.
Not all the NAC in the world isn't going to solve
that. Problem, man.
If you try and research NAC on YouTube,
yeah.
right? The algorithms are supposed to be really smart. Oh, you are trying to take healthcare into your own hands, right?
Right, Betty
but
Ford.
Betty Ford, you would think. No, instead, this is the third result right now on YouTube.
Lil Nas X, I sentenced you to 5 years in Montero State Prison.
Get the kids out.
Gay!
One second, let me see my eyes out.
I gotta be honest.
Unbelievable.
Today's the day.
No, put it down. Put it down, Dave.
He's done. I know you commit to the character.
Oh, it's...
This is... And by the way, YouTube will think that it's more... What I'm about to do, which is educating you from clinical data, is more dangerous or more subversive... Then anal gay sex in a shower.
Little Nas X is like, they're gonna send me to prison?
Yeah, all he hears is, you get 20 years in heaven.
Perfect.
This is what happens if you try and find information on it. As a matter of fact, yes. the article that we quoted on air now can't be found. You have to go through the internet time machine.
Yeah.
Wow. So let me be really clear about
this
thing.
It's a great way to get you to stop looking.
It's a great way to get you to stop looking.
No kidding.
So it was... It's been used in medicine since 1968, this thing, NAC, okay? Was prescribed for chronic lung disorders at one point, so like bronchitis, pneumonia. Like I said, it's been used in the hospital for actual detox as it relates to the liver. Look, here's what it actually effectively... It's been used effectively in things like COPD, lung pneumonia, you know, lung infections.
Yeah.
Why? Because this master antioxidant that your body creates, glutathione, is created in the liver, uses NAC to create it, and it's very concentrated in the lungs. Think of it as a natural mucinex. It's an expectorant, okay? It loosens it. And so, what does that do? It reduces a viral load in your lungs. He's especially good at expectorating. Who, by the way, also probably spent a lot of time in the shower.
Well,
Goth protest too much.
Yes.
Gaston.
Loosens and load.
So cystic fibrosis, COPD, inhalation injuries.
Yeah.
These were, and we have a link right here, National Academy of Sciences. We have links at PubMed. It has a proven track record of limiting liver damage. It's, as a matter of fact, often used as a protocol for people who've taken drugs that could be damaging to your liver. NAC is the first thing people go to.
Yeah.
So even, for example, that's how I found out about it, when they would have me on these antibiotics and steroids. And I said, well, what actually is clinically effectively proven to protect your liver?
Yeah.
There's a lot of crap out there that doesn't do anything.
Sure.
It's clinically proven and been used in hospitals, NAC, beyond any shadow of a doubt. In other words... This is the kind of thing that the FDA should be happy about, because there's a lot of fairy dusting in the supplement world where there's a lot of snake oil salesmen.
Yeah.
This is something that we know works, and this is something that we know has been used for a very long time, and now the FDA is saying, oh, it's so effective, we're gonna say it's a drug. It's not a supplement.
Yeah. And I don't know. I mean, at the FDA, I'm not sure exactly what they're thinking. They don't have a great track record with stuff.
Right.
You know, sometimes they've approved some really bad drugs, but... How do you scare the hell out of Amazon? that much to where they pull it from both Amazon and Whole Foods.
Right.
Right, with some kind of letter. And why? This should be something you're shouting from the mountaintops. Everybody in the alcohol industry that I talked to about this had no clue. And everybody's worried because you drink wine for a living and you're like, I don't want my liver to become a fatty liver and have a problem.
Right.
Why isn't this being like shouted from, oh, just knocking stuff over here.
Yeah.
Why don't you just shout it out? Drunk. Nobody, why? Why?
I'll tell you exactly why. This is just me. I can't prove that this is the exact reason why, but I can prove what it does, how it works, what the FDA is doing, and what is happening at the exact same time that they sent out these notices.
Yeah. So like the opposite of the vaccine?
Yeah, like the opposite of that. So the FDA sent a letter to manufacturers companies saying, you have to stop selling NAC.
Wow.
Right, because it was approved as a drug in 1963, and then because it has a very wide therapeutic window. What does that mean? That means that, generally speaking, if you take more of it, unlike Tylenol, if you take three pills too many, you damage your liver. Mm-hmm. If you take too much of this supplement, your body excretes it. Right, so it's effective and safe. And then I did some digging.
Okay.
And this is a law that's rarely, rarely used. I think it was 1963. It was a drug, and then it became a supplement. And this is unprecedented where the FDA said
it's like a drug. Like that
it was an actual drug, a prescription.
Okay.
So again, no one can say this is misinformation because the FDA has said this is a drug, and they have classifications that have to prove efficacy for it to be a drug.
Gotcha.
The FDA said, actually, it's not a supplement, it's a drug. It was a drug in 1963. Now it's been a supplement for decades, and they're pulling it as a supplement, saying actually it may need to be classified as a drug, which they don't do ever. This is unprecedented for something to go from drug to available supplement to drug so that you guys can't have access to it.
Yeah, and by the way, incredibly cheap supplement.
Incredibly cheap.
Oh, yeah. No, not for long.
So.
No, it'll get there.
We know that it's concentrated in the lungs. Mm-hmm. We know that COVID attacks the lungs.
Mm-hmm.
Did some research. You guys can dive around on PubMed.
Yeah.
NAC was found to reduce the expression of tumor necrosis, the tumor necrosis factor and pro-inflammatory cytokines, which contribute to the eventual cytokine storm seen in severe COVID-19.
Yeah.
Here's something else. NAC specifically scavenges the peroxides released by white blood cells, which can then cause edema and further lung injury. There was a portion of COVID patients, let me set this up, they require a ventilator. Yep. That's a really bad thing. Some people argue it's a death sentence. There are some doctors who say ventilator's a bad idea. There are some doctors who say it's a good thing to use in these hospitals. A lot of doctors think that we're going to them too early. I'm not a doctor, but there are differing opinions in the medical community. NAC was found to be useful as a prophylaxis agent against forms of pneumonia, and it reduced the incidence of ventilator-associated pneumonia by about 20%. So down from 46% to 26%. Wow. That's why the FDA is saying it's a drug. Because it's clinically effective enough to reduce being put on a ventilator. And it's safe, and it's cheap, and it's available. Bam.
We should have been using this forever for this stuff. Because
right.
The flu, typically, pneumonia is one of the biggest killers of people who get the regular flu.
Yes.
Right? So, again, I make my point again. Why is this not on a billboard? Why is this not like fluoride in our water?
There's also been some research that shows that NAC may specifically inhibit COVID by binding to an enzyme and interfering with the virus replication. So again, all of these things. Now, none of these things are entirely proven as far as the COVID stuff.
Yeah.
We do know it's proven to help with liver damage. We do know it's proven to help with your lungs, that it was a prescription available. The FDA says it's an effective drug as an expectorant for your lungs. We do know that it has a very high safety threshold and therapeutic window. We know all these things, and we know that the FDA started saying, you better stop selling this NAC, otherwise we're going to come after you, to the point where every company that I know online stopped selling it except for Swanson Vitamins, right? They were all scared into silence. And this just so happened to coincide with, go to clinicaltrials.gov, a phase 2 clinical trial with 160-something patients for NAC and COVID.
What?
How much you want to bet your sorry ass they're going to find some methylated derivative of this and sell it as snack, and it'll be the new COVID truck?
Mm.
Because keep in mind, a vaccine can only be approved under the Emergency Authorization Act if there is no available therapeutic.
None.
Wouldn't it suck if there's an available therapeutic that's $5 a bottle that you guys declared, the FDA declared, so effective it needs to be classified as a drug?
Yeah.
This is what I talked about yesterday. With conspiracy theories, it's how many people need to be they.
Yeah.
Right? Area 51. The Jews running all the things. The point is, how many people need to be they? In this case,
it's banks.
The FDA makes a call to three people. Bezos, Apple.
Yeah.
And then says, by the way, Zuckerberg, and just make sure you don't allow this information to travel. If someone searches for a way to take their health into their own hands, and they're actually looking for something with clinical data that has been proven beyond any shadow of a doubt, show them guys having anal sex in the shower in pink robes. That's what we think is the best approach. They will call evil good and good evil. But this happened on air, and I was going, why the hell could they ban that? I don't understand.
I thought I got it wrong. Like, yeah. I really did. I thought I was because we were talking about it, and I was like, that article said it, right, yeah, at the time. And then we go back to the article, and it's a completely different, I don't know if we have an overlay for it or not, but it's a completely different article.
They completely changed the article.
It's changed twice, though. Gibbon told me this morning, he went out and pulled it up, and it's like, oh, something on Biden. And then he pulled it up again right before the show, and he's like, it's a completely different article now, not related.
The they're changing, like, what the meanings, hell? Though. They're changing everything.
They're changing meanings.
That's what's scary.
And there's, I've always been out of the business of attributing motive, and I want to hear from you guys, anyone out there who's used NAC, or this is your first time hearing about it, NAC.
Yeah.
They're not claiming that it's dangerous. They're not claiming, hey, don't put this on the label because you can't make just this medical claim. For example, they're saying with a hangover cure, you can't say cure. Yeah, but in other words, you can put, oh, this supports liver health and lung function because it's proven in clinical data. Mm-hmm. That's rare in a supplement. The FDA is not saying, hey, you can't sell this because it's dangerous. They're saying, hey, you got to stop because it's effective. They're not looking out for you. These people don't care about you. In other words, let's say it doesn't work that well. That's not what the FDA says, because they want to reclassify it as a drug. Let's say it works somewhat, but it's incredibly safe and it's been used for decades. Why should you have the choice removed from you? That's what's so scary to me, is the choice is removed from you. We don't believe that you should have control over your own health. And if you look at socialized healthcare, you look at the proposals from the left, do any of these proposals involve putting more control in your hands and more weight into the relationship directly between you and your doctor? No, no. They put more health insurance companies between you. They put higher premiums. They put more bureaucracy, more red tape. These people make a ton of money. And if there's something that's available that your doctor can recommend, which has happened with things like NAC, they make sure that you don't have access to it. There is no reason for this to have taken place, and the FDA and the government have not even argued that they're doing this for your safety. Why are they doing it? They haven't argued why they're doing it at all.
No.
All we know is that it's entering clinical trials now, and it seems to make sense, kind of like you were talking with the vitamin D. I go, well, that's looking at a population making an inference. No, the reason this has entered into trials is because people have said, oh, here's an actual scientific mechanism of action that seems like it could be very effective with COVID.
Yeah.
And it makes sense if we go, oh, what we use it for with COPD, with pneumatic infections, how we use it to help avoid ventilators, where they often would use it as an adjunct therapy. Yeah. They're going, oh, we know we're not just looking at people who consumed more NAC in their diet. We're looking at people who were using this as an effective medication or supplement. And we found a mechanism of action that may help protect the population at large from this pandemic. Make sure it's not available as a therapeutic, because that might affect the emergency authorization.
Yeah.
And I'm wondering where all the naturalists and all the people who didn't trust Big Pharma went to.
Yeah.
Where's Bernie Sanders speaking about? This is the biggest $19 billion. I don't have this at the – we can bring this up as a source here. I'll have it available at ladderofcutter.com and click the references. Pfizer, $19 billion.
Was that a quarter or a year?
In Q2.
What?
Quarter. In the second quarter.
Holy,
that's over $200 million a day. But you know what else? Their blood thinning medication that may be used also for clots, the sales went up double digits. Guess what? Their drug available for people who have heart complications, for example, maybe something like myocarditis, we don't know, went up over 70% as far as sales. Not only that, and we'll have all of these, I'm going by rote here, they fought off a patent law for their anti-clotting drug where no one will be able to do a generic until 2028. Guess what else? Wow. They found, what's the name of that heart drug from Pfizer?
Vyvanse?
Not Vyvanse. It's V something, and it costs $250,000, and they're actually right now putting a bill before the House to make it paid for by Medicaid.
Oh, geez.
So that's a brilliant ploy. Doesn't matter how well these things work if they're funded by the government. That's not a free market. That's $19 billion of your money. Yeah. As far as I'm concerned, we all own the patent. This is my issue with big. You want to develop a drug? Great, develop a drug. And I think you should be as profitable as you see fit. My issue is when you make that profit at the expense of the taxpayers.
Yeah.
It's not a free market. And the people in power right now are doing the bidding of these companies. There is nothing wrong with a free market economy for new drugs and medical developments. There is something incredibly wrong with the FDA being in charge of what you can do with your own body, acknowledging that something is effective, that you have access to, pulling it, and then making sure that we funnel tens of billions of dollars per quarter into a company for a vaccine that seems to reduce hospitalizations and severity, but doesn't do what many people thought it did. That's why you're pissed off. You wouldn't be pissed off if someone else wasn't vaccinated if you weren't a proxy and thought that it would affect you.
Watch Louder with Crowder live, Monday through Thursday, 10 a.m. Eastern.